How's everyone doing today? Awesome. My name is Matthew. I'll be your moderator today. So let's get this underway. So, anybody have any questions? How are you?
Me. How did both of you get cast for Fresh Prince? Like, how did you get picked overall? I'm sure there were like thousands of people applying.
They were on a second ago. They turned them on.
Yeah, they were on.
Oh,
I'll do it.
Hello.
Yes. Hello. Hey. Hey.
Okay, I'll start with my experience with being cast. She's asking about how we were cast on the show. For me, I know I had to audition. I went out on audition for numerous things, and I got a call to audition for the casting director's assistant. So I auditioned for the casting director's assistant, and then I got a call back. I don't know how many auditions you did. I did the casting director's assistant, then I did the casting director, and then I think I did the writers, and then I did the producers, and then I did Quincy Jones, and then I did, which was great, by the way, because Quincy is so awesome. He's a great audience, especially if you like what you're doing. And then I think it was like the studio, I had to audition for the studio, and then the final one was having to audition for the network. And you were in New York.
I wasn't there.
Oh, no. Right, so you weren't there for that. And when we did it in California, we were, like, it was two Hillarys. It was me and one other girl. There were two moms. It was Janet Cooper, at the time, and one other mom. And I don't think James Andrews was there, but it was like two guys with a dad, Alfonso and somebody. It was like, you know, it was down the wire like that for the last. For the last audition, and then that was everybody was there. Like everybody knew that from the very beginning. They were all skis and they just went through. And yeah, it was nerve wracking.
I'm glad I missed that. That
was really nerve wracking. Very, very, you know. But everybody was they were really rooting for it. At that point, they were like, they were really rooting for me, and they were like cheerleaders in there, so it helped a lot. But it was a long process. My process was, I think it was short. Because I was in New York, that's where I'm from, and I had done a pilot for NBC the year before with Tevin Campbell and Sayida Garrett, and it was like a black family, like a Partridge Family. It was called Welcome to Velvet. It didn't make it, but they were like a singing and dancing family from Indianapolis. That didn't make it, but my understanding is the network remembered me from that and then brought me into audition for Fresh Prince in New York. And I did one audition, it went well. I was a kid, so I was auditioning for things all the time, and it was easy as a kid to just throw it away, so I forgot about it. And then, and then I got called back, and that time was with the casting directors, including Jones, who flew into New York. And I remember my mom and my aunt being so excited about Quincy Jones. I was like, ooh.
I was like, okay, that sounds cool, whatever.
He's the nicest, he is just the kindest man. And the second time I had to rap, and I had read the script. They had, for whatever reason, I hadn't read the script before the audition. I only had the sides, the short piece of material that they wanted me to audition. So I had to make up a rap in the lobby, like make it up. And I wish I had the piece of paper because my mom was like, "You're on your own with that." I can't. And seriously, she couldn't help. So I made up like it was more of a limerick than a rap. I'm from New York. I want to go back to California. I don't know. It was something bad. And I did. I felt good about the actual audition of the sides, the lines. When it came to the rap, I didn't. I was awkward. I felt like, oh my God, that was the worst thing I've ever done in my life. But luckily, I think that's what they were looking for. So, and the only reason I wasn't at the test is because I was doing a play at the time.
Okay.
that I was committed to. I couldn't this was it was an off-Broadway play, but with Patty Winston, she was directing it, and so I couldn't leave because I was committed. But I'm kind of glad, because having gone through the network process since then, it's nerve-wracking. So I'm kind of glad that I was working out, couldn't do it. But I knew that was happening, and that they had to go through that, and afterwards, then I found out that I got it. And it changed like my whole life and my family's life. So then,
well, I'm glad both you ladies were cast, because you're fantastic.
Thank you.
I can't see anybody else playing those roles.
You back there? Yeah, you.
Awesome.
Stand up and ask a question.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
So, I've seen outtakes of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, and there have been many funny outtakes, so I was wondering, what is your funniest memory that you've had from the film, like the funniest moment you remember in the film of Fresh Prince?
Can I say
something? Yeah. Okay, this is an outtake that a lot of you have probably seen it to me. I don't think I've ever laughed this hard in my life. And they filmed it. And it's when, Will lies to Alfonso and tells him, he did something to Nia Long, he killed Nia Long somehow, right? His girlfriend. And so Alfonso freaks out and thinks he did something that killed her. And he runs out of the kitchen. And then does anyone remember this? And he runs through any of the freaking.
Yes, I'm always going around and around the elevator.
And it's like there for 5 minutes. How awesome. Do you remember that?
Yes.
And he just started doing it. He just out of nowhere. He just started running around the halls and up the stairs and through the college elevator.
Yes.
And he ran and dragged himself across the kitchen floor.
Yes.
And then he ran into the audience, into the bleachers of the audience, and he ran around screaming.
Dying.
Quick question. Do you have a favorite memory of the late James Avery?
Yeah.
Uncle Phil?
Uncle Phil. Favorite? I know a favorite.
Was he like stern, like in person, or was he like a big fat softy?
He was really, his Birkenstocks. Everything that I believe about acting and performance, just art in general, and the power it has to teach and heal and tell the truth about people and their lives and what's in their hearts, I learned from James Avery. And so
the
memories that I hold very dear are the note sessions that we would have at the end of our run-throughs. And, oh my gosh, the things he would say. I mean, I couldn't tell you verbatim, but I was a student. I learned that to be the purpose of what we were doing, what it was really about. And so when the show means anything to people in a emotional way or a social way, or much of that is due to James.
How was it working alongside Will Smith?
He's so boring. Very, very much what Will is like. I remember I said, has anyone seen A Shark's Tale?
Yes.
I remember I said something to him about seeing A Shark's Tale, and I said, it was so weird, watching this animated film, and I felt like you were really there, like more than, and it was animated, but even more than when I see you in other stuff. And he said that was the first time since Fresh Prince that I got to just do whatever I wanted and just be me. And, that's what it really came across, even though it was a fish, came across. And I think, that's the thing with Will, is all of that, he's very generous, he's very open, he likes to have fun, but he's incredibly professional. And he's a sponge, he hears something today that interests him, and he's like, you know, sucks it right up. And he'll learn and he'll master it by, you know, next week. He's like, he'll know it. He's really, really bright that way. And but always on his toes and very much with you in the moment right there, excited. And I think, so he's a lot of fun to be around. He's definitely a lot of fun to be around. And he doesn't mind falling on his face, which is really fun to watch.
So, Karyn, I understand that your birthday is coming up, so happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
You are a Libra, that's awesome, so am I, so am I. And I watched this movie called Ladies Man, right, with Tim Meadows. So what was it like working with Tim?
Tim was very much, I don't know if anyone's, if you haven't seen the movie The Ladies Man, or maybe you've seen the sketch, it's on Saturday Night Live, but, you know, he's a really weird character, The Ladies Man, and Tim was in character all the time.
Uh-huh.
And when he's not really giving a lot of it, he's still got this really laid back, kind of, or he did, he doesn't all, but he did get really kind of laid back. Thing going on, so you're around that all the time. He's very, very funny to work with, and really, he's cool, good director guy. And Reggie Hudlin directed; he was great.
Always cool.
Hi guys, welcome to Canada, and thank you for sharing your talents all those years. Love that the kid growing up on the show. I was just wondering if there are any roles
you guys had
turned down and
then
regretted later.
Oh, me? Wait, do I have to say who they are?
There are. There are a couple. I think if I'm old enough that I have regrets. Some happened while I was in college. I wanted to finish school, and so I chose to finish instead of leave. But there's a part of me that's like, I could have left for a little while, like, go back. there are always those moments in life, but I think what I do believe, even though it doesn't take all the sting away, is that if you change one thing, you change everything. And I really like the way things turn out.
In a world of reboots and sequels and all that, do you think they'd ever try to bring the show back for any reason or continue it in some form?
I honestly think without James Avery.
Yeah.
I don't. I mean, before James, I would have had different. Before James passed, I would have had a different answer. You know, it's hard to wrangle Will because he's so busy. But after with James's passing, I think it's really hard to imagine that we could have a reboot without him.
The dynamic, ridiculous, and his conservative.
He's just such a, I mean, he's so much the heart of the show.
Thank you for all the joy that you brought to our lives from that show. It's just been amazing. I know both of you have really beautiful singing voices. I was wondering if you
could. I was wondering if you could
do a little sing along of the theme song.
I don't know where you guys are going to rap along. I told you I can't rap.
I'll start off. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, your playground is where I spend most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cooling out, shooting some people outside of school with a couple of
Regis Philbin was one of the most fun people to act with on the show. He was really funny.
Yeah.
Really fun. And really fun to have banter and, you know, act with. He surprised me. He was voice to men.
Voice to men, yeah. Yeah.
Tom Jones was like a night. Oh, interact with that. That was really fun to watch.
You used to go to Tom Jones last
week. We went to Ulta One.
Oh, okay.
Come back down to the movie.
he played my father. He's an alcoholic, and who left my character early in her childhood, and he finds out he's sick and wants to make amends and come back into her life. And it was incredible. Working with Charles Dutton is just, I got to do it twice, and I got a chance to do a little bit of Shakespeare with him. He has a Shakespeare program in Atlanta. And I just, like you talk about being a sponge, I tried to be a sponge every single moment. And there were some real kind of emotional exchanges that we had to have in that movie. It felt like, it didn't feel like work at all because the level of work was so high that it's like why you decide to do what you do and go through what you go through in order to do it.
See, I want to see the movie, but the only way you get it is online, I guess. I tried to get like,
you know what, we did it for a television network in the States. Oh, but I guess it's not here. That's too bad. But yeah, it was wonderful.
Yeah.
Thanks for the time, ladies.